and so, by the storm's fury, he lost all that he loved most in this world, his ship and his shipmates. But he was washed ashore, alone, the only survivor. Then the monks found him and took him to their monastery, where they tenderly nursed him, never asking his name or his country. And gradually, he grew stronger. Now, as he slowly recovered, he saw that the holy men collected tiny colored stones and, with great patience and loving skill, made pictures from the stones to decorate their chapel. And the pictures told a story of a mighty bell made of solid gold. For days without number, the holy men labored to make this mighty bell. They made ready a great cauldron, and under it a fire burned day and night. Then came the gold. Gold from the ends of the earth. Gold offerings of the crusaders. Gold urns from the lands of Islam. Gleaming, liquid gold. A kingdom of gold. Gold idols, golden rings taken from the harems, from wives, from princesses, from courtesans, gold money, gold from ships and mines and caravans, from mosques and palaces and sacred cities, gold stolen by grave robbers from the tombs of the pharaohs, golden cups, golden plate, treasure won by conquering armies. And from its hiding place came the fabulous chain of Nimrodan, of the 10,000 golden links. At last, the huge cauldron was so filled with molten gold that no more could be added. Then it was poured into a gigantic clay mold. For days it stood cooling, until the hour struck when the clay was torn away. And so the great golden bell came shining into the world. They smoothed it, they polished it. Then they called on it to speak. And they ran back in terror and in awe and covered their ears. For this was the mother of voices.